friends. I just wanted to take a moment to say thank you for all the support for my first video about A Song of Ice and Fire. I got a lot of really nice comments with lots of ideas and a lot of support on Twitter, and it's just really nice, and I'm glad people seem to like it and have an interest in this topic, and I can't wait to share more with you guys. Speaking of which, I'm gonna go away now and let you watch the video. Okay, thank you again. In part one, I shared the parallels between Daenerys Targaryen and Cinderella. I explained they both dream of happiness, are raised by abusive siblings, they both lose a shoe, and they both earn their identities from fire. I explained why it is important that Cinderella embraces who she really is, and in this video, I'll share why Daenerys must do the same. In the Brothers Grimm Cinderella story, Cinderella's stepsisters cut off parts of their feet to trick the prince into thinking the slipper fits them, because of course he will marry the girl who fits the golden slipper. The eldest went with the shoe into her room and wanted to try it on, and her mother stood by, but she could not get her big toe into it, and the shoe was too small for her. Then her mother gave her a knife and said, "Cut the toe off. When you are queen, you will have no more need to go on foot." The maiden cut off the toe, forced the foot into the shoe, swallowed the pain, and went out to the king's son. Then he took her on his horse and his bride and rode away with her. They were obliged, however, to pass the grave, and there on the hazel tree sat the two pigeons and cried, "Turn and peep, turn and peep, there's blood within the shoe. The shoe, it is too small for her, the true bride waits for you." The stepsisters maimed themselves to try and fit the slipper so they may become queen. It is not unheard of for people to cut themselves on the Iron Throne when they are being careless around it. As a matter of fact, there's a superstitious legend that claims Maegor Targaryen was killed by the throne itself, as he was found bleeding upon it. It is said the throne killed Maegor, for he was unfit to sit upon it. So in both stories, those who are unworthy bleed on the slipper or the throne. During the present story of A Song of Ice and Fire, many contest for the Iron Throne, believing themselves to be the true heir. Meanwhile, the rightful heir is on another continent, dreaming of her birthright. It happened that the king gave orders for a festival which was to last 3 days, and to which all the beautiful young girls in the country were invited, in order that his son might choose himself a bride. Three is important in stories, and especially the story of Cinderella. She visits the ball 3 times, receives 3 gifts, has 3 abusers, and she is the 3rd child among her and her stepsisters. The rule of threes is essential in Daenerys' storyline, and this is made explicit in her 2nd-to-last chapter in A Clash of Kings, which takes place in the House of the Undying. The dragon has 3 heads, she has 3 dragons, and she is the quote-unquote child of 3. 3 fires must you light, one for life, and one for death, and one to love. 3 mounts must you ride, one to bed, and one to dread, and one to love. 3 treasons will you know, once for blood, and once for gold, and once for love. Daenerys has already had 2 weddings, and she has fled from both on her various chariots, or the mounts. She fled her wedding with Drogo on her mount to bed, and after marrying his Darzo Lorak, she fled the fighting pits on her mount to dread, which is Drogon. The prophecy from the House of the Undying and the story of Cinderella seem to indicate that Daenerys must have a 3rd wedding or attend a 3rd event in which she will ride away from on the final mount from the prophecy, the mount to love. It's also interesting to note that Cinderella dresses in silver and gold to the ball, and the Targaryens are explicitly described as having silver gold hair. The bird threw a gold and silver dress down to her and slippers embroidered with silk and silver. She put on the dress with all speed and went to the wedding. When the prince finally finds Cinderella, it is when she is home and in her true form. Then she seated herself on a stool, drew her foot out of the heavy wooden shoe and put it into the slipper, which fitted like a glove. And when she rose up and the king's son looked at her face, he recognized the beautiful maiden who had danced with him and cried, "That is the true bride." When Cinderella seats herself on the stool and it is revealed that the slipper fits, it makes me think of a woman sitting on a throne and being crowned queen, especially because when the prince declares Cinderella his true bride, he is essentially making her a future queen. If the Iron Throne represents the slipper in the Cinderella story, that means Daenerys, our Cinderella figure, will leave behind the Iron Throne. Only then can she be the true queen that the realm needs and that she wants to be. He took Cinderella on his horse and rode away with her. Doesn't that sound like a mount to love? As they passed by the hazel tree, the two white doves cried, "Turn and peep, turn and peep, no blood is on the shoe. The shoe is not too small for her, the true bride rides with you." And when they had cried that, the two came flying down and placed themselves on Cinderella's shoulders, one on the right, the other one on the left, and remained sitting there. This imagery of Cinderella with a dove on each of her shoulders reminds me of Daenerys with her baby dragons on her shoulders. This is where Cinderella's role in Grimm's story ends. Although the story isn't over until the stepsisters are blinded by the birds pecking their eyes out, this no longer has to do with Cinderella herself. This indicates to me that Daenerys' story will end after she fulfills her role as queen. I am of the opinion that Daenerys Targaryen will marry a third time and flee the role of being a political figurehead during some kind of celebration or dance, perhaps even a battle, and ride the Mount to Love north to take on the role she is meant to and fight against the White Walkers alongside Jon Snow. Just like how Cinderella has to leave the ball and return to her true form in order to become queen, Daenerys has to sacrifice her birthright to fulfill her destiny. Embracing her identity, being the Dragon Queen and a mother to her people, means she must protect the realm she is queen of. This means she is likely to die, sacrificing herself to defeat the White Walkers, where her story will end. She won't get her fairy tale ending, but before she dies, according to my theory and the Cinderella story, she'll at least get to get married again. And who better for our Cinderella figure to marry than the secret prince Jon Snow? I could totally be reaching here, like Daenerys reaching for the Iron Throne, but it's because I have an English degree and we love to read too deeply into things. If you found any of this interesting, be sure to like and share the video and subscribe to my channel for more videos dissecting the parallels in A Song of Ice and Fire and fairy tales. Comment who you want to see analyzed next or any other thoughts you might have. Thanks so much for watching. Bye!